do it like kind of an intro?
Yeah, we need to do an intro.
I'm Mike Massimino, known as Astro Mike.
I'm Don Pettit, known as, what am I known as?
You don't even know what you are. You're Astro Pettit.
Yeah, Astro
Pettit. So don't expect any tweets from Don.
Well, I tweeted when I was on orbit, but
that was a long time ago. How many years ago has that been now?
Oh, I haven't tweeted for 2 years, but.
All right, I guess so.
Okay.
But it's Astro Pettit, and I'm Astro Mike, and this is the ISS
Mailbag. And this is where people tweet in questions for us.
Right. Luckily, they tweet them to me or to this. What is it again?
Inside ISS.
Yeah, inside ISS.
If they tweet them to you, they're not going to get anywhere.
Yeah, well,
apparently.
Tweet is not my thing.
All right.
So we are going to answer some questions that people tweet in. We're starting off with Irish Space Blogger. What's one question about living in space you wish you had got asked more? And what's that answer? So talk about that from a Hubble repair point of view. What would have you liked to have been asked during your orbital
about the living in space part? That I think generally we can say what we normally get, which people want to know about how do you sleep, how do you eat, how do you go to the restroom, and what do you see out the window. But I think what's really interesting is more of the dynamics of the people living together. Because you're on this really cool sort of adventure camping trip with, in my case, six of my friends for a couple weeks. And it was kind of like, you know, the living part of it was kind of like being with your friends having a slumber party every night. You know, because
wow.
We got to set up, you did shuttle and station.
Yeah.
So you experienced both. So like on shuttle,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, shuttle's like a big slumber party.
Like a big slumber party. Everybody gets out, you know, yeah. you kind of eat together. You're always around each other because the shuttle isn't that large. And you're around each other, a lot, and you know everyone's got their sleeping bags out in the mid deck or some in the flight deck, and it's like a big slumber party for 2 weeks.
Yeah, but station is different. Station is more like
an
expedition to the Antarctic or something. Hopefully
yep.
not Shackleton's expedition, it's more of an expedition. You're going to be there for a long period of time. But anyway,
go ahead, answer the question from the station side or whatever side you want.
What question about living did you wish you got asked more? I suppose about how we go about doing our work. Because people see a lot of fun stuff that we do because that's what they like to watch is astronauts floating around and having fun. But in between all those little fun floating around, we work really, really hard. And we work hard. We're scheduled for 12 hours a day. And we typically work for 13 to 14 hours because they always schedule us for more than what we can actually do. But we're go-getters, so we get everything done anyway. And that'll take sometimes 14 hours a day. And then we work about half a day on Saturday and then maybe a quarter of a day on Sunday. So we work really hard on station. But during our off-duty time, that's when you see all these fun little videos of us floating around and scarfing food out of the air and things like that.
So you would like people to ask you more about your work.
Well,
so you
know, that and just to realize
about what you're doing.
That we are there. It's serious work. It's a dangerous place to live, and we do it sort of like what an Olympic athlete does. An Olympic athlete makes his sport look like it's easy. You see someone working on a parallel bars. He's got a smile on his face. He's twirling his body around like a baton. He makes it look easy, but it isn't easy. And we do that. When we go out on a spacewalk, it looks ho-hum. He's going out on a spacewalk. That's easy. Wouldn't that be fun to do? But it's a whole lot of work to do a spacewalk.
See, you know, and when you and I hear what you're saying, but, you know, whenever I would say something like that, like I'm doing a lot of work, I'm working hard, my mother-in-law would say, well, if you were really doing a lot of work, we would know about it.
Yeah.
See, that's
or
so
if
I couldn't,
you were really doing a lot of work, you'd be at home taking care of the kids.
Exactly. I couldn't get away with that. So I hope no one related to us is, well, I hope they are watching, but.
Let's do this. Yannick, fellow.
Yannick Meyer.
Okay. Did you dream of weightlessness scenarios on ISS back on Earth?
Weightlessness scenarios. What do you think they mean
it's
by
like
that?
Do you fly? You know, I dream about flying all the
time. Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, all the time. Yeah.
But when I was in space, I would dream about walking.
Really?
Yeah. It's like it just
the grass is always greener on the other planet.
Yeah. That's good.
Isn't that good?
Yeah. The grass is always greener on the other planet. Yeah.
So you would dream about walking on because you wish you could walk. I wish I could drive my car.
Yeah, you know, I don't know.
Why do I have to float everywhere? Why can't I walk? Can I walk over there?
Yeah.
Is that what it is? Really?
Yeah, I don't know why, but I would dream about walking, or I'd dream about green things, you know, plants.
Really? What you missed?
Yeah.
And on Earth, what do you dream? So the question was about
when I'm on Earth, about being in space. So
right.
You know, go figure.
Yeah, I dream about it. I dream about the flying bit all the time, actually. And I also dream about going back. Like, you know, there's an opportunity to go back, and we're going to go back and fix the Hubble again. And
okay, now
that sort of stuff.
Now here's one from Liz. And she asks,
Liz L.
Basically, do you get cabin fever when you're on a spacecraft, like space station, or on a shuttle, living in this cramped space while you're servicing?
Cabin fever. What Liz actually said, though, was, "Has anyone ever freaked out?"
Well, but she says sort of like cabin fever.
Oh, sort of like cabin fever. Okay, yeah. Okay. So it's cabin fever.
Yeah. So it's cabin fever. Do you get cabin fever? No. What I find is most people are reticent to go home at the end of 6 months. That's what I find, is that people don't want this experience to end. And I see the same thing in Antarctica, when you've been there maybe 6 weeks, maybe 2 months, and you're reluctant to leave this wonderful frontier environment. You're always happy to see your family, but you're reluctant to leave.
Yeah, I think that sums it up.